$500,000 to Make-A-Wish, the V Foundation, and the USO. This month's PlayStation hero, James Sorensen, won the ultimate E3 experience, an all-expense-paid trip to L.A. to attend E3, passes to the PlayStation press conference, and a VIP tour of the booth led by PlayStation's very own Adam Boyes and Shuhei Yoshida, all by purchasing a PlayStation Heroes theme and registering in our sweepstakes. Our next PlayStation hero will win the ultimate ESPN experience in July. All they have to do is purchase this month's PlayStation Heroes theme and register for a chance to win. No purchase necessary. For the official rules, visit PlayStationHeroes.com. And best of all, 90% of this month's proceeds will benefit the Stuart Scott Memorial Cancer Research Fund at the V Foundation. To learn how you can become the next PlayStation Hero, visit PlayStationHeroes.com.
I'm just walking with the clouds, and they're still walking by my side. My soul is dancing on my cheek. I don't know where the exit is.
I have short hair, and I'm faced with a few complications. So if you care, try to analyze that situation. You know, man, as the leaves fall on the ground, my soul is gone and running round and round. So please do it well. Just break the spell. Why don't you do it right? Don't run another fight. I'm not creating my flow with my ego. I'm taking off my hood and I'm venturing deeply in the wood.
PlayStation. Once upon a time, in a kingdom far, far away called Long Island, New York, a little girl named Meredith fell in love with a princess named Rosella, and my love affair with King's Quest began, and I cannot explain how thrilled I am that it is now coming back. I am joined by Lindsay Rossel, who is the producer at The Odd Gentleman, who are the people I have to thank for making all of my gaming dreams come true and bringing this game back. Thank you so much for being here, and thank you guys so much for this game.
Well, thanks for having me.
We're going to do a little bit. You're going to be playing this game. Yep. And guys, I don't know if you've ever done this before, but doing an interview and playing a game when there might be a little bit of lag on a live, you know, segment is a little difficult. So the fact that you're multitasking,
we'll see
more
how
power
it goes.
To you. We're going to see how it goes. We're just going to play through it.
Yeah.
So the story starts, we saw from the trailer, with our beloved Graham retelling his stories to his granddaughter. Mm-hmm. Was that your idea with the narrative from the very beginning?
Yeah, so we got together and just wanted to kind of figure out a way to both update King's Quest, but also make sure it had all the core from the beginning, right? It's a beloved game for all of us, and we know for everyone else, and it's really important that we paid homage to that. And it's been, you know, 20-ish years since the last one came out. King Graham's gotten older, like he just has. And so we wanted to be able to use that and share both this game with the younger generation, much as he's sharing his stories with his granddaughter. And we really wanted to bring that all together.
That's so great, too, because so many of people that are my age who are playing this game in like elementary school, you know, they're older now, they have kids, and it's, you know, sharing it with your children, getting so excited about the game, it really, all the charm and humor is back. And and Christopher Lloyd.
Yep.
How did you guys get your hands on him to do Graham?
I mean, we went through a lot of voices. So you want a magical old guy, right? So that's like what you're going for. And often that is attributed to a British voice. But Graham's not British. So we were going through all of these things trying to find, like, who has that quality that's just so warm? And it almost feels like there's a sparkle in his eye as he's telling you these stories.
Oh, my God.
And can tell you these puns, and you're just going to be like, oh, my God. Like, sure, Grandpa. And so we heard this video, Christopher Lloyd. We're like, him, please, please, please. And CRT made it happen, and we couldn't be more thankful. Like, he's our Graham through and through.
That's awesome. All right, so let's play through a little bit of this. We'll go through nice and slow with this.
So this is just one scene from the first chapter, A Night to Remember. We have actually reached this point where there's a missing bridge. This is something that's happened a couple of times through Daventry. You're encountering these missing bridges. And the knights on this other side of the rope are all in this tournament to become the new royal guards of Daventry, basically. And in this scene, something we really wanted to do is, it's your first day in Daventry, and it's kind of like your first day in school. Like, they're bigger, they're stronger, they're faster than you. And how do you deal with those problems? So let's actually go talk to this knight and see what's up. You'll also notice that a little button came up with a little talk symbol, and so we're using just a contextual button to be able to access things. I also have an inventory, and bring that up there, and it'll focus on a character from there. So for us, it was really important to keep that point-and-click style, but while modernizing it. And so this is Graham doing his intro.
Yeah. That's fine. So you guys actually kind of bounce back and forth through the timelines.
Yep.
What kind of challenges does that present with skipping timeline and keeping the narrative flowing?
And for that, we actually use it. So there's a narration that Graham and Gwendolyn provide through the story. So they'll provide a lens to how you're experiencing everything from there. So there's the modern element of Graham, or the story taking place in the present of the story. And then there's also them coming in and being like, well, maybe that part didn't happen, or maybe you're coloring the story. And the whole idea is, Graham's telling the story to his granddaughter, and you get to color it. There's no, like, bad Graham or evil Graham. Graham is always good, but the decisions Graham makes are the way he approaches problems. So is he a compassionate fellow? Is he a brave fellow? Or is he very clever? And through those, that changes the story you're telling and who Gwendolyn becomes.
Wow.
So
that's really, really cool. Okay, so what I love so much about the King's Quest series was there were always puns, there was always lots of charm and lots of humor. How are you guys integrating that in a way that kind of has, like, the inside joke of, like, what we knew back then, but still keeping it modern and fresh?
We have a lot of jokes. We tend to improv in the office to come up with different things. We want this game to be about exploration and curiosity, right? So the old games are so much about, try these things. Don't be afraid to try. Don't be afraid to fail and don't be afraid to die, in a sense, right?
Like, King's Quest, afraid to try and make Grammy a carrot.
Exactly.
Right.
You might eat the wrong pie. You might no longer be able to beat the game. We don't have any of that. You won't be able to make it so you can't beat the game.
No dead ends.
No full dead ends at this time. But you can die. But we want you to be able to just try and have a good time. You'll discover lots of different elements of dialogue and little Easter eggs throughout, many of them paying homage to the old games. I mean, we open with the scene from King's Quest I of Graham getting the mirror from the well and the dragon, and that's how he became a knight. And then we reverse back to talk about the new tale you've never heard before. So yeah, it's really important we hit that.
Cool. Okay, so we've chatted with our friend now.
Yep, we've chatted with our friend. Let's see. What they would have told me is basically, we have to stay at our post. It's King's orders. There's Proclamation 728. We cannot leave unless someone is in dire need of, in distress. And it has to be of a life or death nature. So I need to get rid of them because I need to try to join up with those knights. So I'm going to head down here. And I'm going to be solving some puzzles for you. So if you don't want to know about puzzles, you should just, like, cover your eyes. So I see this little tree. I've shaken trees before. You'll also see my icon's now a hand because I can use the tree. There's a little beehive above. Maybe I can create distress doing this. Let's give it a try.
Come at me, bees.
And unfortunately, a beehive falls on the other side. So I'll try to go run into the bees, but I can't make it there in time. All right, well, great, that's not going to create distress. I kind of look around, and I see, you know, there's water, but there's also these rocks right over here. And earlier in the game, I've used these. So I'm going to walk up to them, and I can now do an action. So it's the action button situation. It's not platforming or action platforming by any means. I'm just going to push over to the right, jump again. The guards are actually yelling at me, like, stay off those rocks. It's dangerous. And I'm like, well, let's see what happens. And in Graham horrible swimmer fashion is now drowning in the river, and they're screaming distress, abandon post, and they're running down to come save us.
This, it looks so good. I'm kind of like blown away by graphically how good it looks. I mean, obviously it's come a very long way from the original series that we all remember, but it's gorgeous. There's much depth and detail.
A lot of this is actually hand watercolored.
Wow.
So we will take 3D models and print out the UVs and hand watercolor them, then scan them back in to make the world that you see here.
Oh, because that's simple.
Yeah.
Yeah. Keep it simple for yourself.
Sometimes we make dumb decisions to make pretty things.
What did Ken and Roberta think when they saw this?
I mean, a few months ago, we had the honor of showing them the game. To say we were nervous would be a complete and total understatement. Matt and I, like, hadn't slept and freaked out. And so we get there and we turn it on, and they were just like, oh, it's so, like, we give them, like, the preamble, and they're just, it's so pretty. And we start talking about, like, Graham being old. She's like, well, of course he would be. And we're like, okay. And she was, we kept going on, and she started talking to us about the design elements, and we were like, this is how we're approaching it. That's exactly, and she's like, that's exactly how I would do it. Then it kind of became like a design game jam with Roberta, and we're sort of crying in the corners. We're trying to keep our cool. And she was so lovely sharing all this, and gave us the biggest compliment of all, which is like, this is the game I would want to play.
Yeah.
And like, for Roberta to say that is just, it means so much to us, because that's what we've been trying to do is, you know, we wanted to make this game that everyone would love, the fans would love, she would love, you know, it would introduce it to new people, and getting her stamp of approval. And she continues to chat with us and help us when we need it. Like, you can't ask for
anything
better.
Having her consulting on this is just be like, I'm sorry, is this my life right now? Like,
I know.
What's going on?
There's a little like,
oh my gosh. Okay, so this is A Night to Remember, Chapter 1.
Chapter 1.
Chapter 1. So that leads me to believe there might be more chapters.
Only time will tell.
Only time will tell. And then this is maybe more seasons, because if we're going to bring back Graham, I know another princess who probably has a grandson that she could probably tell stories to.
This is coming out really soon.
I can't believe this.
Yeah, we actually just announced we're coming out in the late July. So you
PS3 and PS4?
And PS4.
Wow. That's
definitely should get it.
All right, Lindsay, I could talk about this game all day. So I'm going to come by and stalk you at your office so we can do more of this. Thank you so much for being here. Up next, Justin goes hands-on with Thumper.